Welcome to Capital News Service for February 27th, 1986. With Steve Zimmerman, Julie Brown, and with sports, Dave Schultz.
Students from the Olympia and surrounding area high schools put their talents to work and came up with some very artistic pieces that were displayed at the annual high school art show. The gathering of the students' work was held President's Day at the Capitol Mall. A few of the numerous participants were Scott Ripley, Trig Hoff, and Terry Raikkonen from the ceramic categories, and Christine Steele, David Miranda, and Kevin Herbert entered drawings. We congratulate these students for their artistic achievements.
Mr. Knowles' 5th and 6th grade classes have been contracted by South Puget Sound Community College to rebuild a 2-mile nature trail. They have reconstructed 3 bridges and cleared the 2-mile trail. There are 7 students involved in the work crew program. They are Dan Brady, Robert Gear, Charles Kyler, Juan Ortez, Jerry Phillips, Ernie Rapoli, and Ken Hahn. Each of these students earns a grade, plus they receive minimum wage for their time and effort. Capital News Service would like to wish the work crew the best of luck on their future projects. And now here's Sharon with the student government report.
Arena will be on Friday, February 28th, with A through G going first, H through P second, and Q through Z last. Be sure to get cleared for spring sports. First turnout will be March 3rd. The banquet for winter sports will be March 18th in the cafeteria at 6:30. It has been decided that there will be a Hawaiian dance on April 11th, which is Gaias Girl. The dance will be held in the cafeteria from 9 to 12. A quick reminder to seniors interested in national scholarships. There's a list of those available in the Pod D Secretary's office. This has been Sharon O'Reilly for the Student Government Report.
The Drama Department is putting on 4 one-act plays. The plays Red Carnations, Mind Over Matter, The Still Alarm, and a series of vaudeville skits will be performed the evenings of Thursday, February 27th at 7:30, Friday, February 28th, and Saturday, March 1st at 8 o'clock. The plays are being directed, casted, and totally produced by students under the supervision of Mr. Herrings. We would like to wish the Drama Department a great success.
Last Wednesday, the Agricultural Department had their annual open house. Many of the students involved in FFA put a lot of hard work into this year's event. Most of the displays were made by Mr. Argitis' students. Dave Marty brought in a taxidermy display and also contributed some of his guns for the gun display. Other exhibits, including birdhouses and feeders and various landscaping techniques, were made by wildlife classes. Also, many animals were brought in by FFA members. We here at CNS would like to thank everyone who contributed to the agricultural open house and made it such a success. And now, a word for those of you with senioritis.
Hey seniors, don't be like Ryan and waste your days away. Let senioritis pass, because graduation is only 65 days away.
On February 18th and 24th, the debate team held the league tournament here at Capitol, which included 11 local schools. This district tournament determined who will participate at the state competition on March 8th. The team as a whole swept the sweepstakes award away with a score of 180. Elmer received second with 160, and Oldie third with 54. The team is sending 14 separate members, 3 alternates, and 18 in all to state. All of the 9 events possible will be represented, with only 4 being seniors. Capital's debate team has only the best in store for the future. All the weekend tournaments and the hard work has certainly paid off. Congratulations once again to the whole team, and good luck at state.
As many of you know, there has been a new program introduced to Capital, that being the boys' intramural volleyball team. The program is led by both Mr. Kelleher and Mr. Roberts. It not only teaches guys the skills and techniques of volleyball, but enables them to have fun, too. The guys meet every Wednesday before school, and it is open to any male at Capital. Mr. Roberts hopes to someday compete in the BHL, but for now, it's just an intramural sport. If you are interested, contact Mr. Roberts or Mr. Kelleher. Now, here's Dave with sports.
This year's gymnastics team only sent one Cougar gymnast to state competition. Angie Grant qualified on the beam at districts and took her routine to state, which was held at Camp Meridian High School. Although Angie did not place in state competition, she still has 3 years left to do so. We here at CNS would like to congratulate Angie on this year's performances and would like to wish her the best of luck in the future. Last weekend, the boys' swim team traveled to the University of Washington to compete in the state meet. The Cougars captured 8th place out of 33 teams and scored higher than any other team in the BHL. The team was led by seniors Bobby House, Tom Taylor, Mike Bell, and Dave Johnston. House took 4th in the 100 fly and was part of the 400 free relay, which took 5th. Taylor also had impressive swims with a 5th in the 200 free and 3rd in the 500 free, bettering both of his previous times by a considerable margin. Bell and Johnston aided in the overall results by scoring in the 100 back and breast. Johnson also earned a 6th place medal in the 100 free. Congratulations to all the Capital swimmers who competed in the state meet. The wrestling season also came to an end last weekend with a state tournament in Cheney. Capital sent 4 wrestlers and an alternate to participate in the tourney. Those who qualified in regionals were Greg Woods at 101, Rolf Jensen at 158, Steve Vessel at 178, and John Kaufman at 190. Kirk Stevens also qualified as an alternate at 141. Some early round losses kept the grapplers out of the championship bouts, but they all turned in excellent efforts. CNS would like to congratulate all wrestlers who competed in postseason competition. The boys and girls basketball seasons came to an end for Capital teams last week. The guys lost a couple of tough road games at Tumwater and Centray before returning home to knock off playoff-bound Aberdeen by 1-54-53. Brad Tamberg had 12 points and Dan Blatt poured in 10 in the victory. Last Friday, Olympia came in with the best record in the BHL and looking for a league title. The Cougars jumped to an early lead and played even with the Bears until the fourth quarter, where foul shots made the difference. Chris Christopher scored 19 points and ended the season as the league's leading scorer, and Brad Tamberg had 18 points in an outstanding effort. The girls' basketball team just missed a playoff spot and finished with an 8-10 record. Injuries and illness caused a late-season slide, with 4 straight losses ending the season. Penny Roberts finished the season as the league's third leading scorer. She also set season and career records for most rebounds. Angela Smith also set a season record for assists. CNS would like to congratulate both the boys' and the girls' teams on exciting seasons. Few of you probably realize that in addition to his DECA and annual duties at CHS, Mr. Eby is also involved in officiating at high school football and basketball games. Last night, he officiated the game between the defending state champs Mark Morris Monarchs and the Centralia Tigers. Mr. Eby has been involved with this kind of work for 8 years, and he works out of the South Sound Officials Association. Because he teaches here, he's not allowed to referee any of our games. Too bad.
For Dave, Steve, and me, this has been Capital News Service for Thursday, February 27th. Good luck in arena.